Sag. Welcome back, y'all. Today we're gonna be doing Who's Coming Towards You. Next 72, y'all. We're gonna go ahead and get these readings pushed out for y'all. Go ahead and hit that like button for me, y'all. Turn on the notification bell, and we're gonna go ahead and get started. Hey, y'all. Hey, welcome back. Let me go ahead and stop playing with y'all. Today we're gonna be doing my we're gonna be using my ghetto deck though to see what's going on for you in the next 72. Hold on, y'all. Because I just got stuff everywhere. Need that pen top. I don't know where my blue pen went, y'all. I always be losing shit. Like, seriously. Okay, my bad, Sag. So, who's coming towards my Sagittarius Collective? Next 72. Who's coming towards my Sagittarius Collective? Sag, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus sign. That's a blank. Ooh. Next time we fuck, I don't wanna fuck, I wanna make love. Give me some more predictions. Next 72 is coming towards Sag. Whoever this person is, they real mysterious. Like, not mysterious, but they real, it's hard for you to figure this person out. They don't really, like, tell you too much of how they feeling. You gotta just try to guess with this person. Y'all feel like this person only focused on one thing and one thing only. For some of y'all, you want to talk to this person, but you like, damn. For some of y'all, this person could be wanting sex from you first. They like, shit, okay, we can do all that talking shit later, but give me some right now. You like, goddamn, unhand me. The fuck? Somebody aggressive with you sexually. Some of y'all got, whoever this person is coming towards you, they Mr. or Mrs. Moneybag. Like, they got their cash flow up. Whoever this person is, they could have just got a windfall of money recently, or they are very, financially stable. This person is really driven. They focused on one thing, and it's they bag and they bag only. But when they ready to have sex, they like, they don't play no games. Some of y'all, you got somebody coming towards you that could be mad at you about some money. Whoever this person was, they could have thought that they was going to get some money out of you, but they thought wrong. So, and it's like they see you as somebody that got money, or you got like a high cash flow, and they like, well, shit, you can give me some of that too. And you like, no, this ain't that. This person is mad at you. For some of y'all, this could be somebody that you was sleeping with. They could need like a handout, a favor or something, and you like, no. Yeah, you and this person, y'all not even really in a relationship. Y'all in a pending relationship, whoever this person is. So it's not really even there yet. You and this person never really made it to the relationship stage. Y'all could have just been like friends with benefits or something like that. Some of y'all could be considering this person as somebody that you do want a relationship with, though. But you could feel like whoever this person is, y'all have that type of relationship to where it's like we argue, we fuck, we make up type shit. Argue, fuck, make up. You and this person have a lot of angry sex. Like, it's like a pattern for y'all. Y'all do it over and over again. It's like we love each other one day. The next day, we about to argue, we about to fuck, we about to have angry sex. And then we're going to get mad again, and then we're going to do it all over again. So it's like, you and this person kind of toxic to each other. Eat, fuck, make up. That's what y'all do. Y'all go out to eat. Y'all have sex. Y'all make up. And then y'all do it all over again. Get mad all over again. Whoever whoever this person is, they could like to do their makeup, or they could like to have their makeup looking nice. This person like to come off real presentable. For some of y'all, if this is a female, they could even be a makeup artist. Alright. This person could, they could be losing, like, their self-esteem. They could have a hard time, like, figuring out who they are anymore. For some of y'all, this person could have lost themselves in a relationship with you, or lost themselves while they were trying to be with you. And it's like this person is blaming themselves for how things went with you, and they just really don't know how to act towards you right now. If y'all listen to Layden Green, the song is called Myself. This is how your person is feeling about you at this current moment. Soup. If y'all getting ready, whoever this person is that you having sex with in the next, some of y'all could be having sex in the next 72 hours. But whoever this person is, you don't like to pull out when you're having sex with this person, and they really love that shit. I'm just gonna let you know. They love that. They like, yeah, that lets me know that you mine type shit. With you doing that. So they like that shit. They kinky. You got somebody else coming towards you that you look at as an op now. You don't really look at this person the same. Y'all could really be beefing, like real life beefing. And it's like you, whoever this person is, they fold, they could be lying, telling you that somebody folded on you, or somebody's lying to you about something, because they know that you and this person are meant to be together, or that y'all really like each other. So whoever this person is, they coming in to like interfere on your connection. So if you get somebody trying to like tell you about the person that you fucking with, or that you trying to get into a relationship with, block it out. Block it out, because it could be like some noise that you don't need to be hearing. You got a connection that's meant for you. We literally got twins out here, and we got written in the stars. So it's like, whoever this person is that you're dealing with, it really is a person that you're meant to be with, like a soulmate. This shit was written before you even thought it was coming into fruition. Like, you may not have known this person was meant for you, but it was always designed to be that way. Or I ain't gonna say designed, like you forced to be with a motherfucker, but you may not have known, but trust me, if you've been praying for your soulmate, God knew who to send to you. That's all I'm gonna say. They knew exactly who to send to you. But for some of y'all, you really do have people in the middle of whatever this is that you're trying to build with another person. Some of y'all could be a twin. You could have a twin. Some of y'all could have twin kids. And for others of y'all, you could just be dealing with your twin flame at this current moment. And you could have a random ass bitch trying to fuck it up. Some of y'all really do have an op coming towards you, though, in the next 72. Whoever this op is, this somebody, this could be like an ex of yours that's always trying to come back your way, or always trying to get you back when they feel like you walking away from them, or when they feel like you getting ready to fuck with somebody else. This person always comes stumping in on your life, because they feel like you sprung on them. This person still feel like they can get you anywhere they want you. And whoever this person is, this ex that you look at as an op, they have a real messy vibe. A real messy vibe. Like, they not right. They could be talking shit about the person that you fucking with, you know, calling them a random ass bitch or something like that. But don't listen to his edge, okay? What does Sag need to know for the tarot portion? Next 72. Y'all getting ready to come out of hermit mode because y'all got some a wish fulfillment coming towards you. And it's been like a long ass waiting period for you. You've been waiting on this wish or whatever this is to come in. Whether this could be like you finding love or you finding happiness or finally deciding to go after that. It's been a long time coming. Some of y'all been spending too much time by yourself, and now y'all got somebody to come in and spend that time with you. But somebody may fuck it up. Somebody may self-sabotage it. Somebody may self-sabotage this because they don't want to really adapt to change. This could be you doing this, Sag, or this could be this person. Somebody is not open to the idea of being happy elsewhere or being somebody's not open to the idea of, like, they don't feel like they're ready to have a family life or ready to just be so committed to one person or another person. Be patient. Just try to balance the situation out as best as you can. Whatever situation is going on in the next 72, don't get mad. Just breathe, y'all. It's gonna pass. Some of y'all could be dealing with another Sagittarius. A Scorpio could be relevant. A Virgo. What else does Sag need to know, next 72? Somebody, you could be scared or hesitating to move forward because you have somebody else in your energy that you feel like you owe your loyalty to. But whoever this person is that you're trying to hold loyalty to, this person, they know you've had a hard time seeing things for what they really are. They know that. And whoever this person is, it's like they play on your intelligence. They watch you and they wait to see when you're going to make a move or when you're going to do something new or different. It's like this person waits until you're no longer sad or grieving over them, and then they come into your life. Yeah, some of y'all already know the truth. Some of y'all already, you honest. You already know how to use your discernment when it comes to certain situations. A lot of y'all are real sharp at the tongue. You don't mind letting motherfuckers know what's up. Some of y'all are getting ready to admit to somebody that you want a relationship. Be letting somebody know that you want to hold on to a relationship. Either you want to hold on to a connection, you're not ready to walk away from it, or you could either be telling somebody else the truth about you wanting a connection. Either way it go, a decision is being made. Some of y'all could be dealing with a Taurus, a Gemini, a Libra, or a Aquarius. Some of y'all could be dealing with a younger water sign, a younger Cancer, Scorpio, or a Pisces. Where somebody is texting you in the next 72. Somebody is texting you in the next 72 hours because they're having a hard time moving on from you. And they feel stuck because they don't know where this relationship is going. Or they don't know where the situation is going with you. But all they know is that they want a new opportunity. They like, shit, I don't know where it's going, but I know I want another chance to invest in this. Some of y'all in the next 72, you're gonna be watching your investments grow. Some of y'all could have a pay raise coming towards you, or you could have like some type of business, something that you invested in, you're gonna see money profit off of it. So So if some of y'all was looking into like stocks or bonds or something like that, or you was looking into like a new project, but you don't know how it's gonna work out for you, I'm hearing it's gonna work out. It's gonna work out good. You're gonna get growth out of this. Others of y'all, you getting ready to invest into a relationship. Y'all tired of waiting. You want to be happy. You could be dealing with a Gemini. Okay, let's get advice for Sag. Hold on, y'all. Advice. We can use mermaid messages for this. Shit, I keep doing that. What's the advice for Sag? Next 72. Advice for Sag. Sag, don't be so quick to make a decision when it comes to certain things. Like, if you feel like you need to rethink a situation through, then that's exactly what you need to do. If you feel like you need to take time to relax or just take time to chill to yourself or figure some things out mentally or emotionally, then that's exactly what you need to do. You need to take that time for yourself. A lot of y'all, you have a hard time asking people for help. You just have a habit of running away from situations instead of just letting people know, like, hey, I need help, or hey, I'm not healing, or this is what it is. Some of y'all don't make a decision until you get yourself fully healed, because the last thing you want to do is move forward to something that's right for you, or move forward to a blessing that's good for you, and then fuck it up because you're not over something from the past, or fuck it up because you're not fully healed, or, you know, whatever it is that you're going through. You just don't want to bring past trauma into your new blessings, because it's going to taint the situation, and you don't want a tainted blessing now, do you? No, you don't. So that's the advice I got for y'all, Sag. Thank you so much for watching, y'all. Hit that like button for me. Subscribe to my channel. Y'all be easy in this next 72, all right? Bye, y'all.